Friday the 12th of April 2024 is going to be remembered as one of the turning points in cinema history. At booth SL505 at the NAB show in Vegas, Blackmagic Design dropped two massive bombshells. They were named the URSA Cine 12K and 17K cameras. So let's explore what these new cameras cost, who and what types of work they are made for, why Blackmagic has made them, and whether you should buy one. As we predicted in this video, packed inside these new cameras were two monster sensors. The first is a 36x24mm 12K full-frame symmetrical RGB sensor boasting 16 stops of dynamic range. The second, an even larger IMAX 65 size sensor at 50.8x23.3mm with 17K of resolution, appearing to be roughly three times the size of the original 12K URSA sensor in a camera named the URSA Cine 17K. Unlike their predecessors, these cameras on the surface do not appear affordable, but they really are starting at $15,000 before tax, and I'll explain why before the end of this video. Apart from the price stirring debate online, both cameras have already received some harsh criticism and have been challenged over the claimed 16 stops of dynamic range. What you're watching now are RAW files downloaded from the Blackmagic Design website, and after briefly playing with them in Resolve 19, I can safely say the doubters are wrong. The files show a huge amount of manipulatable latitude in post. And as a previous 12K URSA owner, I can say the 12K full frame has more latitude in the recorded files. This is most likely due to the larger photo sites in the URSA Cine. You have to remember, my older URSA 12K and the URSA Cine are the same resolution, but the sensor in the Cine is twice the size. I don't have the exact figure of how much bigger or what the difference is between the pixel pitches, but it must be significant. What hasn't been mentioned is if the sensor is DGO or dual native ISO. This information is just omitted from the product page. For example, if we look at the Pixis, we can clearly see it's listed as a dual native ISO camera with a rating of 400 to 3200. But if we go over to the URSA Cine page, all we have is this dynamic range of 16 stops listed. There is no other sensor commercially available that performs this well that isn't a DGO sensor. And if I remember correctly, the last DGO sensor that Blackmagic Design sold was also not advertised, and that was the Fairchild sensor in the original cinema camera. So I can only draw the conclusion that this is a DGO sensor and that this is how Blackmagic Design is getting the 16 stops of dynamic range. But this is just what I think, so drop a comment down below and let me know your thoughts here. As for the 17K, I can only speculate that it's built on the same architecture and just has a larger variant of the same sensor design. No footage has been released for download, there is no product page, so it's hard to make any assessments. The colors in the 12K Cine in the footage look gorgeous and are incredibly rich. I mean, they are what we have come to expect from Blackmagic Design cameras' synergy with Resolve's Gen 5 color pipe and post-processing. Now, apart from Arri and Fuji, no other company making cameras has this much deep insight and understanding in the end-to-end color management process. And as Fujifilm are yet to release a proper cinema camera, it's clear that the new line of cine cameras is targeted firmly at high-end productions and the foothold that Arri has held over the film industry for more than a decade. You only need to look at the changes in design and the technology deployed inside the cameras to understand what I'm suggesting. At 3.95 kilos, these two cameras are packed with a 5-inch 1500 nit off-side touchscreen monitor, operator-side fully rotatable touchscreen, new OLED EVFs, which I have covered in this video here. They have LANC, XLR audio connectivity, Ethernet, Fischer, Lemo, 12GB BNC, USB-C, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, RS, and EXT connectivity. They come in PL, LPL, and EF lens mounts with better buttons and button layouts, same industry-leading easy-to-use menus and operating system. They retain the beautifully designed touch control heads-up display, robust aluminium design, new super-fast media, and out-of-the-box accessories that won't break the bank to buy, considering the target market and the cost of competitor products. All I can say is this, if I had just bought a Sony Berano for $25,000 with its terrible rolling shutter for 10 grand more and needing a stack of accessories, I would be kicking myself. Plus, I think Blackmagic Design has realized that high-resolution multi-format sensors are the way forward in the industry, as all full-frame or larger sensors can be used to acquire smaller formats. But the URSA line are the only cameras on the market that can shoot 4K, 8K, and 12K open gate without cropping into the sensor or losing any quality of doing so. This alone brings so much value to the end user and positions the 12K and 17K cameras as a better value proposition option when compared to the Venice, Burano, C500 Mark II, Arri LF, and Arri 35. The URSA Cine even has a 9K 4-perf Super 35 mode, which will be fantastic for a stack of people who own a lot of legacy glass. And the larger 17K sensor will be perfect for a new emerging markets like creating 14K content for the Apple Vision Pro, high-res stuff for Netflix, Prime Video, and Apple TV, or older markets like tourism advertising, live sports like the AFL in Australia, where games are played in outdoor stadiums in high-contrast settings, which will benefit from a better dynamic range camera and could use the extra resolution to zoom in closer to the live action for Ultra HD or even 1080p broadcasts. Let's not forget the VFX industry. And any filmmaker wanting to be able to shoot an IMAX movie without being stopped by the cost of the gatekeepers. But no cost has yet been announced for the 17K camera. However, I would predict it's likely going to retail for somewhere north of $20,000 just for the body. Again, still cheaper than a Burano, with way more upside as it will attract niche work for owner ops while still being able to shoot every other resolution on request without cropping in on the sensor. These two cameras position Blackmagic Design to be a company whose products only really compete with their own products. It's obvious that these cameras roost at the top of Blackmagic's camera line. But if you put all the new sensor technology aside, every aspect of the camera and accessory ecosystem has evolved from the 12K Super 35 variant. The new 12K and 17K cines are a little bit longer and a little bit squarer, but are still a good size for shoulder work and full-blown productions and designed to speed up every aspect of production work. But they also start at 2.5 times the cost of the current URSA 12K, which is a phenomenal cinema camera in its own right. But if you're not a rental house or a production company, should you buy this camera? The simple answer is yes to anyone who wants the best camera Blackmagic Design can offer. What did Grant Petty say?
Money was no object. One of the things we didn't care about cost, what could we actually build? We wanted to build our dream high-end digital film camera. We wanted to have everything we could have ever wanted. We wanted no limits on features and no matter what the cost was. And we also wanted to design a whole new generation of image sensor. And we wanted that camera to integrate into the whole post-production process, plus support global post-production workflows with Blackmagic Cloud. And we've done all that.
I think that's what they've achieved. Blackmagic has clearly learned a lot over the years and listened to its user base. Most of their first generation cameras have not included internal NDs, but the URSA Cine does, with up to 6 stops of electronically controlled filtration and an OLPF. The inclusion of full-frame open gate BRAW in 12 and 17K is a win, but many will be disappointed with the exclusion of ProRes codecs. For me, this is not an issue, as they're easy to create in post, and I would always prefer RAW for final color. Plus, now everything seems to be shifting to immediate cloud-based workflows, so is ProRes, which is a much heavier codec, even needed anymore? I mean, the Cine can live stream from sets as it features an inbuilt hardware streaming engine that supports RTMP and SRT streaming to major platforms or directly to clients via Ethernet, high-speed Wi-Fi, or even your mobile phone. You're also able to shoot in just about every aspect ratio known to the film industry with no restriction when it comes to anamorphic. And being able to shoot RAW in frame rates of 120 frames per second in 12K and 224 frames per second in 8K is just ludicrous. For a full frame sensor to be able to do this means that the readout speeds have to be incredibly fast, and that leads me to believe that the rolling shutter will be very well controlled. At some of these frame rates and resolution combos, the data will be massive, meaning the data will also need to be read, written, and cleared very quickly. To get around the incredible file sizes and speed required to do that, Blackmagic have introduced a new proprietary media system. These are like mini hard drive mags and contain a number of M2 drives striped into a RAID config, forming the 8 or 16 terabyte capacity. I'm guessing the blades are the same ultra-fast ones Blackmagic uses in their cloud stores. Some people are already suggesting that these are expensive, but that's just simply not true. They're retailing 8 terabyte for under $1,700. My 4 terabyte CF Express Type B cards from Angelbird cost over $2,000 each, so Blackmagic is offering double the storage at half the cost of the best alternative brand. The dock is a different matter though. At $1,700 for a dock to download your footage, that's a bit expensive, as every other camera manufacturer is basically using CF Express Type B cards and readers which can be bought for less than $100. But Blackmagic did say you can use the camera to download the footage, however, that's not really practical in a set environment. and I don't think there are any normal card slots anywhere on the camera, at least that I can see. In Blackmagic's defense, you do get extremely long record times with 8 terabyte mags, which will give you around 4 hours of continuous shooting in 12K or 20 hours in 4K. So depending on what you're doing, you may just be able to download at the end of the day. I wouldn't recommend it, but you could do it. This is my only criticism of the Cine line of cameras, the camera mag reader cost, but I'm sure it will just come down in cost over time. The entire end-to-end production ecosystem that Blackmagic Design has been building towards over the last couple of years has finally been fleshed out, especially with the addition of their new cloud stores and other connected Resolve devices. So if you can afford them, they'll be worth every dollar. And I'm not just saying that for studios, as I don't think these cameras will be specifically better to work with a crew. I think they'll work great for solo shooters as well, especially if you do a lot of narrative, VFX or commercial work, or if you just want more resolution and more dynamic range. Camera accessories like LiDAR have come very far in the last couple of years, which can fix the lack of autofocus to a certain extent and do it good enough for most solo shooter needs. But I also think that companies that have post-heavy workflows or fast turnarounds will really benefit from the cloud connectivity and the immediacy that offers. I will try to get my hands on either the 12K or the 17K cameras for review, so consider subscribing to see that content. Personally, I think these announcements are pretty impressive, but the important thing to remember is that no camera is specifically designed for you. I look at the 12K and think, yep, this could be it, but being able to own a 65mm cinema camera, now that's more uniquely interesting and would be the variant I would buy. But with no product page or price or release date, maybe it's actually not coming to the market yet. In the end, you'll have to remember that all camera companies are trying to cover a variety of filmmakers and production types, and whatever gaps they leave will be filled by accessories companies. But if you're out there just boiling with online rage because Blackmagic Design hasn't delivered something for you, there's plenty of other good camera manufacturers that may fill your needs. And if that's the case, here are some other videos that can help you on your creative journey.
Swipe up, tag your friends, like and subscribe, comment below. If I make this follow, don't let this flop.